Logical force versus reflexivity. Logical force is the obligation that person feels to act in a given way to what someone else does. While reflexivity, on the other hand, is what Holly says to Fernando bounces off and affects her response, and vice versa. Watch closely for their reactions to each other in this video. You will see how a small argument about something very stupid and simple turns into a huge argument, which ultimately leads to a divorce. I am Jenny Blaisdell, and I approve of this message.
Dun, dun, dun.
Having a wonderful day.
Fernando, why is the toilet seat left up? I hate that. Fernando, honey.
What?
Are you kidding me? Stop leaving the toilet seat up. It is so annoying. See, can you see in here? I mean, it's just so easy to put down. Look at how easy it was. I care, okay? What? I don't want to touch pee because it's on the seat.
Neither do I, but that's why I just leave it up.
Well, can you please put it down from now on, please?
No.
I'm so annoyed.
I just want to leave it up all the time now.
Seriously?
Yeah.
I want a divorce. That's
what?
It.
What?
I want a divorce.
Are you kidding
We're
me?
Over. It's done. Done.
Whatever.
Okay. Fine. Fernando!
What?
I don't understand. Stop leaving it up.
I think a divorce sounds good.
I do too.
Yeah, I think
just because of that. Seriously?
Yes, because of that.
Yeah, let's break up. It's done.
We're
it's
done.
Over.
Over.
Just get out. Get out of my apartment. Get out. Get out now. Just leave. Seriously.
Where'd it go?
Fernando.
Get
out! Leave! I don't know why you're still standing at my door. Why are you still here? Get out! Go! I don't care if you have a car. Just leave.
I need my shit.
I don't care.
So in this fight, y'all saw Fernando and Holly getting into it. Holly just came at Fernando with such force that the only way he felt he could respond to it by saying, "Like, okay, let's get a divorce." Didn't care. Holly just kept going. And Fernando just was responding in a way that he felt would end the situation. And the reflexivity in this video is that Holly's words that she was saying Fernando were saying to him bounced back to her, making her more and more angry as she went on. And we'll go on to video two now.
Oh, interesting. Oh, hi guys, how are y'all today? Alright, so in this next video, we're going to talk about depth and breadth of penetration. Okay, so first we have breadth of penetration. Now, breadth is where you have lots of topics and you don't really get too, you know, concentrated on one. You don't get too deep into it. Okay, next we have depth of penetration. Now, depth of penetration is where you really have maybe one to three topics, and you really get deep into them, really deep. All right, so as you'll see, if you watch closely, you'll get the difference. Thanks, guys. Have a great day. Bye. Hello, welcome to Willie's. My name's Holly. I'll be taking care of you. Can I get anything for you right now?
I'm waiting on somebody, but if I can get two coffees, that'd be great.
Yeah, absolutely. I'll be right back with them.
Thanks.
Uh-huh.
Hey, what's up?
Hey, how are you? I ordered you a coffee.
Oh,
that's
yeah.
Cool.
Awesome. Thanks.
Yeah. Have you read this book? It's pretty interesting.
No, I haven't had a chance to read it yet.
Really?
Go. Okay. Anything else I can get y'all?
Thanks. No, we're good.
Yeah,
all right.
Good.
Enjoy.
Thanks.
Cool.
So have a good weekend?
Yeah, pretty good actually. Just went out to a couple bars and stuff.
Oh, cool.
That was about it. How about you?
Stayed in, studied, went out once.
Yeah.
That's about it, yeah.
Yeah, I was kind of stressing over a test, so I had to go like home early usually every night. So
which test?
This one class, language communication.
Oh, I heard that class is really hard.
Yeah, it's really hard. It's a lot of studying, for sure.
I bet. A lot of group work.
Yeah, a lot of group work, definitely. But my group's pretty cool, actually.
Oh, so that's good. Because I heard some groups just hate each other. They're crying constantly. Just...
Hey, Jenny.
Hey, what's up?
It's not so good. This day is just terrible.
What's wrong?
Well, me and my husband are just getting a divorce.
For what reason?
Well, it wasn't even that big of a deal, but he kept leaving the toilet seat up. And so we just got in this big argument, and I kicked him out. He didn't even take any of his stuff, though, so he's going to have to come back and...
And you're going to have to deal with him again?
I'm going to have to deal with him again. And I don't know if I can do this. I'm just so frustrated. Like, what do you think I should do?
I mean... It doesn't seem like that big of a deal, so...
I know, but...
Maybe you can work out the issue.
He didn't even seem to care. It was just like, he just went with it. Like, he wanted a divorce too, and I don't know why.
I think maybe he's just scared.
He's scared?
Yeah. I think I don't know. I don't really know what he's thinking, but...
I don't either. It's just making me so frustrated. Like, what should I do?
I don't know. I mean, I think he's probably going to end up regretting it.
I think he will, too.
Back to you. So I don't think you should finalize anything at this point in time.
So don't draw up the papers.
No, don't.
I just don't want him to come. Talk?
Yeah, just try talking first.
Should I, like, invite him over?
Yeah, I mean, maybe you might want to do it in, like, a... public area, so things can't get too heated, obviously.
A public, like a Starbucks or something?
Yeah.
That might work.
Yeah, because you don't want it to get heated because, you know, people feel less obligated to do that when you're in public. So,
yeah, maybe I should do that.
Yeah, I think so.
Well, we'll see. I mean, I don't know. I guess, yeah, okay. Thanks for talking to me.
You're welcome.
Alright, so what are we getting...
I could really go for a beer right now.
I know.
Studying
for
this test.
I'm, like, super thirsty.
Yeah, that too.
A tall one, actually, I think I want.
Yeah.
Hi, guys. How are y'all today?
Good.
Okay.
How are you?
I'm doing great. What can I get y'all to drink or eat or anything?
Can I get a tall Ultra?
A Michelob Ultra, staying slim, I like it, drinking the beer. What can I get for you, sir?
I'm going to get the same tall, but Dos Equis.
Dos Equis, All right, now are y'all 21, huh? Yeah?
Yep.
I hope so. All right, I'm going to go with that. Oh, they're back.
Cool. She was
kind of weird.
Yeah. I'm glad we're both thinking that
one. I don't think I want anything to eat.
No?
Nah.
Well,
do you?
I mean, I might. I could eat.
Yeah.
But, maybe
later. All right, so here we go. Little Ultra for you. Little Dos Equis for you. So, I know that yours is a smaller beer, but actually they're the same amount of beer. Trust me. They're the same amount, okay?
Really?
Yeah.
It looks like, doesn't look like the same.
Okay,
not
well,
at all.
They are.
I mean, I shouldn't complain. I got the bigger one, but
they are. Are you going to be okay with that? Because we don't really have any more of those glasses, sir.
Yeah, I guess so for now. That would be fine. I think my phone's ringing.
So, I mean, is that going to be okay?
Actually, can we see your manager? This is unacceptable.
Yeah. I'll be right back.
Thank you.
You do that. Gosh, that's totally smaller.
What the heck?
Right?
And
hey, what can
seconds.
I help you guys with? And I ordered an Ultra.
Okay.
Hi. Fernando.
So we ordered tall beers, and Holly here said that these are actually the same size, but I'm not sure if I believe that.
Yeah.
You know, this kind of looks like it's less beer than hers.
What should we do? I know they're the same. They're the same.
But they're really not. So I'm going to show you.
They're not?
No, they're not. I'm sorry. She's new. It's okay.
Oh,
okay.
That explains a lot.
Here, look. I'm going to dump this out, and I'm going to show you that it's not right. And do an experiment.
Okay, let's see. We'll find out.
So this is an experiment? This is cool.
Oops, I got a
little. Oh, see, guys? Oh, man.
Yeah, this isn't going to get to the top.
I knew it.
So
you were going to charge me more.
I'm sorry, guys. I'm new.
I'm going to let you have this beer in the house. What about mine, since you just poured it out in a different cup?
I'll bring you a couple new beers. Sorry about
awesome.
That, guys.
Thank you so much.
No problem.
Thank
sorry.
You. Okay, so what happened?
I don't even know. Like, we just got in this big fight, and then she just, like, freaked out, kicked me out.
Over that?
And, yeah, over the stupid toilet.
That is the stupidest thing I've ever heard. So y'all are done?
What is going on in here? God, Fernando! Seriously, we're not broken up. What are you doing with her?
You said you wanted a divorce.
But we're not divorced.
He
told me.
No, we're not divorced yet. Papers have not been drawn up.
Yeah,
we're sitting so close. You're like intimate. This is like 18, 0 to 18 inches apart.
So we're not together anymore. Why does it matter?
It does matter. Get out. Get out. Get out. Fernando, you're in big trouble, mister.
Why? What? You said you wanted a divorce.
I do.
Well, what? Why does it matter if she's here?
Because this is my apartment. You're sitting in my friggin' house.
Jenny, sweetie?
What?
We need to have a talk with you.
Yeah, we really do.
About?
It's about your grades.
Really? What's wrong with them?
They've been slipping. We noticed on the report card.
Okay.
Yep.
What do you have to say for yourself?
Can y'all please get out?
I mean, there's been all this partying, late nights. I don't know. You need to bring your grades up.
Can y'all get out of my personal space, please?
Personal space?
Yeah.
I don't know what that is. What is personal space?
Well, it's 18 inches to 4 feet, so you need to back up a little bit, so you're not in there.
We're the parents. Have you ever heard of that?
Tell her what's up, honey.
Okay, no more staying out late, no more TV. You don't even need to be reading that book.
It's for school.
Throw that over there.
You
I'm here. For a week. Throw that book over there. Done. No more books.
Bye.
Alright, class, so today we're going to be learning about coordinated management of meaning. This is chapter 6 in the book. Go ahead and turn to page 68.
I don't have my book.
I don't either.
Yeah, we don't have our books.
Alright, well, just follow along with me. Family therapy. A father and a mother come to talk about their 14-year-old son who has been diagnosed with Asperger's syndrome, a mild form of autism.
Asperger's.
Halfway through the session. Class, quiet down, please. Made me lose my train of thought. Halfway through the session, it hit me that the boy and his parents were trapped in a repetitive pattern of behavior that CMM calls a strange loop. A strange loop is defined as an unwanted, repetitive communication pattern. Right? Basically, darn, we did it again.
Scene.
All right, guys. Nobody shoot some guns?
No.
No.
Gracie?
No.
No?
No. You go first.
No.
You want me to go
first?
I'm going
to see what it looks like when you do it.
It's not even that bad. Look. Check it out.
No.
No?
Like I'll watch for a second.
No, you first.
All right. I'll go first. All right. Watch and learn. You ready?
Let
Jenny
go.
No.
No.
Gracie?
I don't like
no,
the noise that guns make.
Yeah, I just have really bad anxiety.
Yeah, just hold it. Just hold it.
Like, I'm getting, I feel really tense right now. Like, I don't, I can't do it. I really can't. Like, I can't
you
even
sure?
describe it.
No. I don't want that in my hand. It could go off. I'm not coordinated. Plus, I'm scared.
Well, I mean, someone has to shoot it.
You can keep
That's
going.
That's you.
Alright.
I just feel way too tense to even do this. Like, I can't even be here right now.
Are you ready?
Why are you pointing your gun at me? You're making my anxiety heighten even more.
Alright, just relax and then shoot it. See?
No.
Try? No?
I don't like it.
I feel way too tense to do that.
I'm
sorry.
Guys.
I need to leave.
Really?
I can't be here right now. Jenny, you should try. Just my anxiety is way too
right?
bad for this.
Just
no.
hold it at least.
No.
No?
No.
It's not even that bad.
I don't like guns. They freak me out.
This one's really easy to shoot, actually.
I don't
It comes
care.
Like... I don't know, it shoots really easy.
No,
okay.
It's good.
Alright.
Oh, hello, class. Well, right now you're about to see anxiety demonstrated by Fernando. They're at a gun range with Gracie and Jenny, and they're all friends, of course. And Fernando is about to shoot a target at the gun range. Now, what you'll see is Jenny and Gracie being very uneasy and very unsure about shooting guns. They're very timid and scared about what's going to happen, leading them to be anxious and anxiety about shooting guns and gun control. Hi, Gracie.
Hi, Holly.
So I noticed that today you were feeling a little anxious about being at the gun range. Can you explain a little bit of that to me, please?
Just being around the guns in general just make me feel really uneasy, just tense up, and I just feel really anxious when I'm around them. So I'd just rather not be in that situation.
Okay, so why did you even go if you didn't want to be there?
They told me we were just going to go have a few drinks, and we ended up at a shooting range.
Instead of drinking, y'all went to a shooting range.
Yes.
Well, that's just, that would make me uneasy just thinking about it. I mean,
I'm on the same page.
I know. So. All right, well, thank you so much for explaining that to me.
Cool show. Stop the video.